Here.
And Mr. Fry has tendered his resignation effective this week.
Okay. So, because we don't have legal counsel, so I don't know what, well, I guess it's still a 10-3 votes, because that's the only majority we can have, so, okay. There is no minutes, so we will dispense with the approval of the minutes and go ahead into the site plan submission for McKinley Development. John, you have the floor.
There's a sheet, there's no sheet.
There is no sheet, just say your name and John, I know how to spell it.
Sorry.
John Walsh, GDC Design, 565 White Plum Drive, Ohio. And we're representing McKinley Development Leasing Company this evening. And we're out of Washington Square, and we're glad to, I think, have the final site, the final building for that whole complex before you tonight. We're proposing roughly a 8,681 square foot building that's going to be between Starbucks and Sonic. And with the site plan, we worked with Mr. Benitez and his staff as far as access to those where we have a right in and right out on the maple. I think that'll blend in with some future improvements that we propose for Maple Street. The rear will be full movement access to the site so people can get in and out. Stormwater being taken care of in the master retention pond. So the first part of the project, the building and architecture is going to match the buildings that are right next door. It's going to match the Sonic building and then not the Sonic, but the Starbucks building. And also the one where Lincoln Lizard is in. There's no drive-through proposed for this building. I think we've coordinated with staff and we've had some prior comments. I'm pretty sure we'll take care of those comments. I guess with that, I'll have to answer your questions.
Okay, Jim, comments?
As John mentioned, we worked with them. They submitted a revised set of plans, which you do not have. You received those either Friday or Monday. I have not had a chance to scrutinize them and see if they've met all. The major concern would be the access onto Maple Street. And they have provided an island there. We'll need to look at that to see if that's sufficient. But the intent is right in and right out only that location. There were some other editorial comments on the plan, some other concerns. But it appears that that must have, but again, we haven't had a chance to scrutinize those. We recommend conditional approval.
Any proposed tenants at this point, John?
I think the one is the far east end is proposed a pet bank to anchor the building. The other three, I'm not sure if they have tenants yet or not.
Okay. Anyone in the audience have any questions or comments on this? Yes, ma'am.
Will they come up?
Please.
Melanie J. Wall, Easy Lloyd Cottage. The Hoover Trail, I think, is immediately west of this property.
Correct.
And I've been wondering how that was going to impact the trail and the safety of those folks using it.
Well, I don't know if you had an opportunity to look at the plan, but I believe they had the curb on the west parking lot, and there's probably an elevation difference of 4 or 5 feet so that there is no connection of their property, the proposed property, and the Starbucks handles that strip parking lot, so the walking path will, go ahead, John, you, I'd like to answer.
For the most part, the walking trails on the state right where it is.
Right, that's.
There's, like you said, there's no connection between the two parking lots for automobiles, so there's no, no new interference there. The grade next to the building, we're actually proposing a slight retaining wall through parking there.
But you do have the curb on the parking space.
On the parking space, yes. And then it's getting moved slightly back around where the dumpsters are. For the most part, it's staying right where it is.
Yeah. Go ahead, yes, ma'am.
I'm not sure I understand what kind of burial will be between the east side of the walking path.
A curb. Six, eight inch curb.
It'll be very similar, the curb will look very similar as to what you see on the Starbucks side.
Right.
There'll be a grass strip between the path and the parking lot, and then there'll be a curb there.
And will that be the entire length of the property from Maple to?
Yes.
Okay, that's what I want, thank you.
Yeah, what's that distance, John?
It's about 350 feet.
No, the.
Oh, the separate.
It gets closer back by the dumpster. Do you have curb there as well?
Yeah.
There's a small retaining wall.
There's a small retaining wall, then it'll actually go in between the two dumpsters back there.
Okay.
Existing enclosure, proposed enclosure.
Right.
So where it goes along Starbucks Drive, it's more or less staying on the west end.
Did that answer your question?
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome. Questions or comments to the commission?
Question for Jim. Are you looking at a different drawing than we are, David? I don't see it, I looked at that. Yes. Okay, we just, like I said, we just received it.
What I would suggest, first of all, I don't think an approach should be permitted at all. We went through this with Sonic, and that's the reason their driveway in front of their building was extended onto this property for access, so that all traffic then uses the one at Walgreens. I think with the three buildings, with this proposal, Sonic and Walgreens, probably has less traffic, would have less traffic than the traffic around the Starbucks complex, which has no direct access to Maple. I think it just would be a better traffic situation. However, I think if we want to consider it all right in and right out, which would be the minimum, we should approach, you should look at what Stark County Engineer is developing and has recently constructed out on West 40th Street by the strip, that street to the north between McDonald's and the BP station. They put a new island, which I think is their new design for those kinds of right in, right out. And they probably have a detail for that. They haven't formally approved it. They've submitted some preliminary drawings to the commissioners, and they're trying to develop, you know, like ODOT has done with the access approach program. I would think, I would consider if that's what the commission desires, that a right in, right out be designed in accordance with the Stark County proposed standards. Which may not be different with what you, because those typically don't work the right out approach on the Market Street doesn't work. So, other questions? Huh? Oh, I've seen it, yeah. Yeah, I looked at it. questions? What's your pleasure?
I have one more question.
Yeah.
Writing right out. Have the owners expressed a big concern one way or the other about having that?
They originally started wanting a full movement there, so like most of Belvin, wanted a full movement. That would never happen.
I'm looking at actually an aerial image.
Right.
Which route is probably for the next item on the agenda. And we did, of course, just a parking lot, and we forced walls and closing entrances down and add to the street. Of course, we do have the suicide lane down the middle now, so that helps.
Yeah, but my understanding is there are plans in the works to put a barrier there, which will, you know, physically prevent left turn movements out of there.
Yeah, there's a proposed green area that's going to end up being in front of this right in, right out, where the I guess the continuous right turn, our left turn lane is now, so you won't physically be able to make that. We're getting east on Maple, you couldn't make a left-hand turn in, or you can't make a left. If you're going out, you can't make a left turn, hand turn out.
Yeah, I think this plan shows a triangle.
Right.
I think what the county is using is more of a curved approach, a much more defined to make a right turn. You may end up losing a parking place. I don't know how they are on parking, but I think approving the plan with one less parking spot would be much better to get that right in, right out, better design. You know, a simple triangle doesn't work.
I mean, they would prefer that, obviously, they have the right in, right out. For those movements, the rest of the people are going to use the internal roads and end up using the light in or Maple or on
right.
Market.
So. But you're providing access through the signing property anyhow. So
I'm not against the right in, right out, if that's all it can be used for. Well, you was mentioning that.
Yeah, I think if they use
the county's status. The drugstore people just pull in, they don't basically ignore it and turn it into
right. I think with the improvements that are going to happen to Maple Street, that's your physical is going to be restricted. That's the only thing that you can do is a right.
That's a good thing.
Other questions? Is there a motion?
I move to approve the Tim's review.
And the proper right in, right out.
Well, that again, that would be a Tim's discretion.
Well, yeah. Tim's aware, but I strongly encourage you to check with Stark County Engineer's office.
We can do that.
Is there a second? Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bolus?
Yes.
Mr. Guy?
Yes.
Mr. Sierra?
Yes.
Mr. Fleckman?
Yes.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next item on our agenda is a site plan submission for the new Walsh Global Learning Center building. Someone here representing.
Mr. Chairman, just to make it clear on the record, I don't have the sign that she did more because people didn't use it. So I'm just writing their names down as they come so that it can be represented accurately on the minutes.
I'll go ahead while we're getting set up. We have some plans to display here. I'm Shelly Brown, Vice President for Finance at Walsh University. 2020 East Maple Street, North Canton, 4720. And first of all, I'd just like to thank you for the opportunity to allow us to present the proposed Global Learning Center to council tonight. And I would like to introduce to some other people. tonight. We have Brian Greenwell, who is our Vice President for Administration and CIO, and Bill Myers, Director of Capital Projects, as well as our staff from Richdell Bowen Architects from Cleveland. So they'll be able to handle all the tough questions. I'm just kind of here to introduce everybody. Real quick, we're looking at state of the university is good. We just closed out the fiscal year. Positive operating variances, beat our revenue numbers, and the savings looking for next year. Enrollment strong. We're hanging in there. It's a tough competition out there, but everything financially, university is very stable. Fundraising efforts continue to go for this building, and we're really hoping with all the approvals go, if all the approvals go through, that we're hoping to break ground late fall, late October, maybe November. So this is a 44,000 square foot building, and will house a media research center, an area called the Forum, which is where faculty, staff, community members will get together and try and resolve issues, community issues, global issues, a lot of research going on in that area. We have high-tech classrooms, computer engineering lab, which will support our new, we made changes for our computer science majors, and also you probably heard about our agreement with Dayton University. We're having a 3+2 program where students would come to Wall for 3 years, go to Dayton for two, and end up with a degree, master's degree in engineering. So that's part of this building to help support that. We have a very spacious atrium, and we'll be able to, you know, house events, food service, and a real nice area for the students to kind of hang out in. And an interactive video wall, we're still working on that, but very interactive touchscreen, let people know what's going on in the university, and we're hoping that this building becomes a 24/7, open all the time, good place for the students to hang out. So with that, I'm going to kind of turn it over to our architects and let them answer any questions that you might have. So this is Alan Renzi.
I'll move a little closer so we can see.
Again, I'm Alan Renzi, R-E-N-Z-I, and thank you for this opportunity to present in front of you. I don't know what else to add from that introduction. Certainly we'll answer any questions you have. I will point out that we're honored to have been asked to help Walsh with what is considered their signature building. It's a building that doesn't have one specific department in mind. It's really meant to complement all of the departments, all their curriculum, in all of their majors. It's a place where everybody can come together and learn together, learn globally. So it's the focus is really on technology, collaboration, and gathering. So the location, I'm sure you're familiar. Very difficult to see, but the exciting thing about this project is it's the last available space on the co-op. It's the northwest corner of the quad between Dominique and Farrell Hall. You can see it on the map. It's directly along or adjacent to Maple Street. The setback is over 75 feet. It really does not disturb the campus much at all. It's an open lot right now, and it really kind of supports, like I said, the students, the faculty, and even the community. So if there are any questions, we'd love to dig in and answer any concerns, questions you might have.
Jim, comments? Engineer, comments first?
One question, just an architect.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah, I think our renderer probably showed more than what there will be. We will try to preserve whatever trees we can, but the intention is not to block the building. In fact, there will be signage, there's a monument sign out front. So we will replace trees that are served on the quad side of the building, which I think we have rendering. The thing is, they're actually not from there. So this is the view from inside the quad. And there is, as you know, probably know that there are trees on the quad, and they line that sidewalk that is adjacent to our building, and we will replace whatever's disturbed.
That was a comment or a question.
We don't like to, you know, we love trees, but this is, like I said, a signature building,
yeah.
And it wants to be the gateway to the university, and we don't hide.
Right. We did receive stormwater count. It's an underground system, and we haven't had a chance to cursory review it. We're still working on that, so that'll be one of the conditions of approval. I noticed on the quad side, we put a sidewalk in 15 feet wide, which is nice, and then leading out to the street, we narrowed down to 6 feet. Talked with university about the access there and having a center gate type of sidewalk crossing. So I would recommend that sidewalk leading out to the street be wider, and then also to do the center gate at this time to make that crosswalk a better crossing, to protect that. We can work with you on that. And then the entry drive in, but you know, one time we talked that there wouldn't be a whole lot of traffic in there, and then we would actually use the driveway and put like brick pavers or something coming down that driveway. But I think we want to look at how that fits in with what the university wants to do at that location, and we address that at this time for this project and do it together for that. That's more of a recommendation that we give.
Can I just clarify?
Sure.
Are you talking about the sidewalk that runs north?
Correct.
Maybe.
Okay. Yeah.
Just wider to line up with the crosswalk.
Wider, or do we want to, you know, make that drive entrance and put a brick pattern in there or something? But that's something we can discuss with the university's looking along those lines. Address that up. And then the actual crossing on East Maple Street, we'll want to address that at this time. Tie that sidewalk into the existing, because in the future we want to continue that sidewalk on the south side going west to the intersection we're doing at this time. There's several editorial notes regarding the utilities. We're still working on those. I apologize last year about this time. It's a busy time of year for us, for shorthand. We haven't had a chance to do an in-depth review of all the utilities, but we are working on those. One of the things we noticed, there were septic tanks shown on the plans. I didn't see anything to remove. We'll work through that with you, with the other utilities. A dumpster, is there going to be a dumpster for this site specific, or is there another location that you'll be utilizing?
Use a daily building.
Okay. And then, you know, architects love to use large sets of plans. We would prefer 24 by 36 at the maximum. So if you get a revised set, it's only a 24 by, because we don't have any. This doesn't work in our storage system.
So half size, is that what you're saying?
Well,
but I don't think we're going to be able to change our format at this point.
So,
but we could certainly print them half size.
Okay, we'll take half size. And when we get the final ones, we're like a PDF of zoning standpoint, because it's all one parcel, all university land, that's not an issue. I don't know from a building standpoint, when you get to submitting the building plans, but I'm sure.
Yeah, we do it as a pedestrian connector, so we think we've met all the requirements.
Yeah, drainage, that's a lot to that design there, we are looking at that. And those are the only comments I have, recommend conditional approval.
Peter, yeah?
Yeah, what does this building do to the overall parking plan for the university?
Well, it should have little impact, because, like I said, there's actually no traditional classrooms, so it's really not meant to house any new programs. It's really meant to enhance and give other options to the existing programs where they can meet and work, like I said, collaboratively. So we don't see it as being a big demand on parking. And it's just like any other building on campus. There are designated parking areas, and it would be expected that the students would walk to the building.
All right, so we're going to be more specific then. I'm not sure how large the university is from a square footage standpoint, 100,000 square feet. How many parking spaces are available in the current inventory, and how does this building impact that? Well, I'm sure that there's a zoning requirement on the number of parking spaces that this building would generate.
We so have there are offices, but there's
400,000 some sort of staff. Is there enough parking spaces in the university currently to accommodate this building, regardless of
the square footage basis?
We had an internal discussion on that today. It's very difficult on a campus, when you have part-time students, full-time students, and it was mentioned, this probably doesn't generate any additional. And I think the discussion on the planning commission before is it's a self-contained campus. If they don't have enough parking, it's going to hurt them. There's no place else for them, but they're not going to park on Main Street. So it's a difficult thing to get a handle on, because our code doesn't address it for a campus. And I would think, though, with all the due diligence they've done so far, there should be some logical demand drivers versus how many spaces they have today on the university. And I don't buy the argument, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Peter, if I can expand on that, that question comes up every time there is a new building constructed here, and we look at the individual building, and I guess the more critical is the fact that any new construction doesn't delete any existing parking. To answer your first question, I would say if you took the total square footage of all the campus buildings, they don't meet the square footage in zoning. But as Jim has said, variances have already been given because they're the ones that suffer. I mean, they've got space across the street. That's why the city put the underground tunnel in for better access. Now that they own the Hoover Park, that certainly can always be used. But what the commission has been looking at is that any new construction does not, and as I reviewed this plan, there is no existing parking spaces being eliminated.
No.
That would be the issue. And it would be a nightmare to try to say, but I would venture to guess that based on square footage, it doesn't meet the parking regulations that are in the zoning ordinance. But
the grounds do have space for parking growth.
Right.
If they need it.
Right. Campus. Full master plan was not a part of this study to determine what their future needs might be. But you're right, it is definitely self-governing, because if they're losing students because of parking, I would imagine they would be building more parking, because that would be a simple solution to bring in.
But I think you stated just the last available building site on the campus.
No, I'm sorry, no, on the quad.
On the quad.
Yeah, no, not on the campus, the campus certainly was, has more room.
Yeah, so we repeatedly asked, and before, if there is, and probably should be, an update on your master plan, we haven't seen one probably in 3 or 4 years, that would give us a better indication of what you're looking at down the road, what parking may be needed by additional buildings, or be deleted by additional construction. So I would say, on my behalf, I would like to see, on any future submittal, an updated master plan.
Is there a parking Is there a parking management plan in place currently for the university?
Yeah, I can speak to that. We do, and you know, we always say at the university, we don't have a parking problem, we have a walking problem. And we know all of the parking that we have behind the dorms. And if you just take a look at the university big picture, enrollment has pretty much remained flat over the last 3 to 4 years. And, you know, we don't see anything, and to be honest with you, it's very competitive. And so we're not projecting to see enrollment increase significantly. And so that's really, you know, right now we have parking for all of our students and all of our staff. And so this building, unless enrollment increase significantly because of this building, I don't really think that, you know, it's going to change our parking. Does that answer your question?
Answered my question.
Okay.
Other questions or concerns? Anyone out there have any specific questions? Okay.
Is this the first reading of a couple readings, or is this?
No, this is the final. This is
final.
The
final. Okay. Okay.
Approved.
Make an approval to accept this final site plan with the recommendations being added in the Fire Prevention Bureau, which states an access road shall be minimum 18 feet, and the access road to the Farrell Hall needs to be addressed.
And I think Jim has some money.
And Jim's comments of his review. Yes, thank you. All we have is a big trouble.
Is there a second?
A second.
Any further questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Gadd.
I'll be abstaining.
Mr. Fleckner.
Yes.
Mr. Sarah.
Yes.
Mr. Baldus.
No.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Can you state a reason?
We have that in the past.
I'm happy to. I don't have enough information based on the parking to satisfy my position. I would like to see the overall parking plan. I'm a new member of the commission. I don't have a historical perspective.
Okay. We also, if you would contact the law director with a four-member commission. I don't know how the extension vote is cast, whether it's considered as part of the majority of those voting.
My understanding is you need 3 positive votes.
That was my input. Let's confirm it, because that that would be critical to them, they need to know. So, you could request an opinion from Tim, the law director, to know whether this has passed or is defeated.
Would you all state reasons or just?
Oh, he stated it.
I mean, the rest of us need to state reasons.
I don't. I mean, that came as a result of the one we had pending litigation. I mean, more critical is the fact is it favorable or not? So. I don't know how quickly we'll have a new member appointed, but it either passes, depending on the law director's opinion. Hopefully that would be forthcoming fairly quickly so that you can meet your schedule. Okay, do we have no other business before us?
I do expect an agenda, please.
You do expect it. And that would, our next regular session meeting would be September 20th. September 7th. Anyone see a special place to say at this time?
Yeah.
He took your horse up and drank it.
You guys are putting me between a rock and a hard place. I'm sorry, we, you know.
The city was a joke.
Well, exactly, that's what I'm saying.
Well, I'm thinking, I'm lost.
So are you still going to?